Hello, welcome to Bite Size Med. This video is on how hormones maintain calcium homeostasis. There are three main hormones involved in the regulation of calcium in the body: the parathyroid hormone, vitamin D, and calcitonin. Now, I have done these two in more detail in my previous videos. This video is more of a summary, putting all the pieces together. So let's start with what happens to calcium in the body. We get calcium through diet. It reaches the small intestine, where it gets absorbed into the extracellular fluid. It also gets secreted in gastrointestinal fluids and then excreted. This extracellular fluid calcium can exchange with cells across the cell membrane to perform its many functions. It gets deposited in bone. Bone also acts as a reservoir storing calcium, so when bone undergoes resorption, calcium returns to the ECF. A lot of the calcium gets filtered by the kidney, but most of it gets reabsorbed, so the body takes it back, excreting only a small amount of calcium in the urine. Calcium in the plasma exists in different forms, but the free ionized calcium is biologically active. The body is very strict about maintaining ionized calcium concentration within its normal range, because if the scale tips, things can go awry. For example, low calcium excites nerve and muscle cells. So calcium homeostasis is very important. So how would the body try to fix low plasma calcium? By bringing calcium back into the ECF. That's these three arrows going towards it. So we got to use these three organs: the small intestine, the kidneys, and the bones. Let's put them together now. So the body can increase calcium when it's low with these three organs: in the small intestine by increasing calcium absorption, in the kidneys by increasing calcium reabsorption, and in bones by bone resorption. And by increasing calcium, it returns to homeostasis. Now let's add in the hormones. We'll see how they manage low plasma calcium. There is a calcium sensing receptor. This receptor is located on the parathyroid glands, and it can bind to calcium. If calcium is high, the release of PTH is inhibited. If calcium is low, there's no inhibition and PTH is released. Low calcium, high PTH. And this PTH can work on these organs. In the kidney, it reabsorbs calcium, taking it back into the ECF. It also acts on phosphate, because calcium and phosphate are handled together. But PTH throws phosphate out. It reduces the reabsorption of phosphate and increases its excretion. The last thing PTH does in the kidney is it activates vitamin D from 25-hydroxycholecalciferol to 1,25-dihydroxycholecalciferol. This is by stimulating 1-alpha-hydroxylase. What about bone? Its net effect is to increase bone resorption, putting calcium and phosphate into the ECF. But remember, it removes phosphate by increasing its excretion by the kidneys. Lastly, the small intestine. There's no direct effect here. Instead, it uses vitamin D. PTH activates vitamin D, remember, so it can go and absorb calcium from the small intestines. And that calcium goes into the ECF, where we want it to go. We've already started with the second hormone on the list, vitamin D. PTH activates it. Low plasma calcium stimulates 1-alpha-hydroxylase to activate vitamin D. And this calcitriol, which is the active form of vitamin D, also increases calcium reabsorption by the kidney. So it works with the parathyroid hormone. But its effect on phosphate is the opposite of PTH. It actually reduces phosphate excretion by increasing how much is reabsorbed. Its most important effect is on the small intestine, where it increases calcium absorption. Together, vitamin D and PTH are trying to bring the plasma calcium back up again. Homeostasis. Now the reverse. If the plasma calcium is high, these arrows need to be blocked because we don't need them to be dragging more calcium back in. There's enough already. So the calcium sensing receptor picks it up by binding to calcium, and it inhibits the secretion of PTH. That reduces bone resorption and calcium reabsorption by the kidneys. Activation of vitamin D is reduced, reducing absorption of calcium by the small intestine, again trying to bring that calcium down to normal. But there's one more hormone whose role is uncertain, calcitonin. It's not supposed to act physiologically, but is stimulated when the plasma calcium is quite high. And it does this stuff. It lowers bone resorption by directly binding to osteoclasts. On the kidneys, it reduces calcium reabsorption and increases its excretion. It reduces calcium absorption by the intestines, the exact opposite of the parathyroid hormone. This calcitonin is secreted by the thyroid gland, and its role is to lower plasma calcium when it's high. Ultimately, all three of these are going to work together to keep that calcium normal. Three organs and three hormones, the small intestine, the kidneys and bones, PTH, vitamin D, and calcitonin. Those are the three important hormones that regulate calcium. I do hope this video was helpful. If it was, you can give it a like and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.